Hi Karthik. We'll be having Juhi Manglani, a student of George Brown. She landed in Canada via Albania. This route is regarding Albania. So we are waiting for her to join. The Qatar fake news, no, actually I'm not very much aware. We got it on the official Twitter handle, so we can't say it's fake, but we got an update from Qatar Airways as well. The agent has also mailed the airlines and the embassy, so we are waiting for the response from their side as well. So whenever we get the official confirmation, we will definitely post the same email on the story. Please stay tuned for that. Most probably they are saying fully vaccinated travelers do not need to quarantine for 10 days. But we can't say, okay, just we have invite from Julie.
Hi Julie, how are you?
Hi, I'm good. How are you?
Good, thank you. You settle down. Oh, I was speaking, my mic was off regarding the fake news someone asked initially regarding Qatar. Thing is, one of the agent has mailed Harjot, and okay. We'll get the official information from the embassy and the airline. We'll definitely post it on the story.
Okay,
this route is regarding Albania. So you, Juhi, she's a student of George Brown College and landed a week ago, I guess, Juhi?
Yes, 21st.
Okay, perfect. So we'll go with your experience, like how was the overall route expense, and I'll ask some more questions. Please go ahead with your experience.
Okay, so my experience was pretty smooth. I did not face any challenges as such. I'll discuss what documents were asked on different airports. So when I boarded from Mumbai, it was... at the check-in, they asked me to show my negative COVID report and my passport. And that's about it. I was allowed two baggages. My airline was Lufthansa. And then I proceeded for immigration. Immigration was also pretty smooth. He just asked me a few questions as in, which college are you going to? What's your course? And he was asking documents randomly. So there were two friends who were tagging along. So I was asked to show my BBL.
Wait. Sorry, their voice is not audible. We have comments from the viewers.
Okay.
It's audible. Okay, it's audible. Someone said, so please go ahead. Sorry to interrupt.
Okay,
there must be a problem with you.
So at the immigration, documents were asked randomly. So I had two friends who were tagging along with me. So one friend was asked to show his LOA. I was asked to show my BBL, and another friend was not asked any document. So even that was pretty smooth. Then we boarded from Mumbai. We had a layover at Frankfurt. And at Frankfurt, everything was very smooth. We only had our security checks done. There was no immigration there. And from there, we boarded our flight to Tirana. That's the capital of Albania. And it was very smooth. By the time we landed there, we had to just claim our baggages and go towards the immigration section. And the officer just asked for our passport. And he asked us why we are in Albania and where are we going after this and what's our purpose of the visit. So we answered that we are moving to Canada. And the third route, we were pretty honest and we were like, the direct flights are banned. So we had to take we had to go through this route and we are going there to study. So, and there are no visa requirements in Albania.
Did you take any return ticket from India? Obviously, no. Albania doesn't require, but still, any immigration ask you anything regarding that?
No return.
And tickets. Okay, something special happened. The deport case, right? A girl was deported back to India. Will you please explain that? Why?
Yeah, that happened at Warsaw Airport. So our flight, we had a 2-day stay in Albania, and we had to get our RT-PCR reports from there, and then we had to take our flight from Albania to Warsaw and Warsaw to Toronto. So at Warsaw, a girl had her medical expired. Actually, she got a new her e-medical done, but it was not approved in her GCK. So they asked her to wait But then later on, she was deported. And the authorities were checking the documents very strictly in Warsaw. So at
Okay.
Warsaw, they asked everybody to show their negative PCR reports that they got from Albania, their port of entries, LOAs, and a few more documents, passport request letters.
Okay.
And yeah, some were asked to show
Cool.
their GICs as well. But I
So
would suggest that
basically
if.
she was deported because her medical was expired, right? No, no extra
Yeah, her
reason.
medical was expired. She got her new medical done, but it was not approved in her GCQ.
Okay, so basically the thing is, please do not travel until and unless your new medical is updated if your former medical is expired, right?
Yeah, and she had
Okay.
to pay the expenses of getting back from Poland to India, so it's going to cost you a lot.
Perfect. And what was the exact cause? The question from Kartik is, what is your cost for the whole ticket?
Oh, so it costed me around 118. 1,18,000.
Okay.
That was because I did my bookings quite prior to my date of travel, but
Yeah,
now I
and you
didn't get
booked
all my
from
details.
Fernway Bharat Travel, right?
Yeah,
He's the one.
Fernway Tours, that's yeah,
Yeah,
Bharat
he's
Gidon.
also having a tie-up with us. If anyone wants to book, we can book it through him. We can get you in touch with those agents. He's very good. I personally have I'm booking him from booking the tickets for him.
Yeah.
And coming to the okay, the port is done. Frankfurt Warsaw layover. You were explaining something regarding that, right?
Yeah, so Frankfurt was pretty chill. We just had our security checks there. Warsaw was a little strict, I would say, but there's nothing to worry about if your documents are in place. And the
Okay,
deport
and
case happened at Warsaw airport. So because
okay.
that is the last contact for you to like travel, like the last airport before you travel to Toronto, it's obviously going to be a little strict, right?
Yes, correct. And how is the immigration, the third country immigration and the CBSA as well?
So the third country immigration was very smooth. They just asked us three questions, which I also mentioned earlier, that why are you in Albania and where are you going to go from here and what is your purpose to visit the country you're going to. So
Okay,
everything, you
perfect.
just have to be very honest and confident and you just need to have your documents in place. That's about it.
Okay,
And
we have
the
some.
Canadian immigration was also pretty smooth. So when we landed there, we were directed towards the PHSC authorities. They just checked our documents. Oh, I'm really sorry, I forgot to mention that at Albania and at Warsaw, we were also asked to show our arrive can receipts.
Oh, so you have to get this done beforehand, right?
Yes. Yeah.
Okay, we have some questions as well. Please get me in touch with the travel agent. Okay, Karthik, you can DM us. We'll definitely get you in touch with him. Second question, how do we know if the medical is updated in the GCK? It's simple. You can call IRCC and you can tell the representative that I would like to request the initiation for the medical. This is a technical term that you have to use. If you say, please get my medical updated as soon as possible, they will not understand. They do understand, but they will not do it. You have to say, please initiate my medical request. So they will initiate your medical so that it doesn't do it like 100%, but they will forward your medical request to the main officer, VO basically, visa officer, who can get your medical updated as soon as possible. But on an average, it takes around 40 to 60 days for the new medical to get updated in your GCK. New question, do we need any transit visa for Warsaw?
Nope.
No, okay.
You don't need a transit visa even for Albania, and Warsaw was just like a layover, so you don't need any visa for any country through this route.
Okay. Do you have any contact of IRCC? Yes. You can text us. We'll provide you the contact number. And yeah. Anything else? This was left. I'm really sorry to interrupt you in between, Juhi. So anything
No,
was
no, no, no,
left?
no, no, no worries at all.
CBSA was. So Indian immigration was also smooth. Third country and CBSA, they all were
Yeah,
super cool, right?
CBSA was smooth for me because me and my friends we had our documents in place, but there was another case who okay, so in case somebody is not vaccinated and they are required to book a 3-day hotel quarantine, they should book it because otherwise it's going to be a lot of trouble for them. So there was a lady who had to actually quarantine and she did not book a place, her 3-day hotel. And when she landed there, she was saying the CBSA officer that I don't have money to book it and all of that. So that is something that you want to avoid. Of course, if you're fully exempted, you don't have to worry about that because things will be smooth. And yeah, that's about it. And then after that, when we went to get our study permits, my experience was pretty smooth. I was not asked to produce a single document. He just took my passport, and my negative COVID report. He asked me to stand for 2 minutes and he just got my study permit printed. But then there were other officers who were also asking for IELTS scores and GICs and all of that. So it again depends from officer to officer and
what
how
kind
well
of officer you're getting. Yes.
Yeah. Yes.
So, yeah, same question.
But I didn't think anybody faced any problem there as well because there were a few students with us and all of them got their study permits.
Oh, okay, perfect.
Yeah.
Perfect. Sorry, I didn't heard the from starting. So from where are you? She traveled from Mumbai, Karthik.
Yes.
That was a question. Anything? Any question that we are missing? What documents at what were required at immigration in Canada? She has already explained, I guess. And if you need the list of documents, we'll share it to you. Okay, I have one question, Juhi. If even if you are fully vaccinated, do you need? Did you require the quarantine plan?
Yes, we did require a quarantine plan. Not like a like you need to put some address. Okay, so when we fill out our arrive can, we need to give an address as in where we are going to stay at least for 14 days or so. So for that, you just need a plan, but you don't need to book a 3-day hotel quarantine. If you're fully exempted, you just have to show a place where you're going to go after you land.
Yes, because I have been getting a calls regarding that I am fully vaccinated. I need a long-term place. No owner will keep you in a place where already some students are staying because on arrival, either you'll be giving a self-tested kit or self-testing kit or you'll be done on RT-PCR test on arrival test, right? That is what you faced? Okay.
Yes. And one more thing I forgot to mention. So you are not required to quarantine if you're fully exempted, but you will do. You will have an on-arrival test. So by the time the test results are not out, you are not allowed to move out. So you...
So basic 72-hour isolation location is required, like private place, right?
Yes, that's right. Yeah.
So that clears the doubt. That even if you're fully vaccinated, you need a document. That's why I have seen on Airbnb and Kijiji, the owners are selling the documents. That, okay, just take the quarantine plan from us and go for it. But do not do it. Either just go into their property and stay, but do not take the plan and go to your friend's place. In case if you're found positive, there will be a visit from a public health agency officer in that property where you have actually mentioned. And if you're not found, the fine of $3,500 will be imposed on you. So this is a rule that is already on the website. People do not think it's like if you're totally exempted. Sir, sab kehne ka hai, ye sab kuch nahi hai, mushkil aur sort kisi se bhi saath rakho, koi dikkat nahi. Who is this? Mudit Chirag? Okay.
I think you
haven't faced the officer, sir.
Yeah, so there was an officer who visited our property because there are a few rooms that are vacated for quarantines, quarantining students. Officers do visit. Yeah, so
obviously, because as a student, you can't think that it's like hum Delhi ke, mere chacha vidhayak hai. No, it doesn't work over like that. Because as a student, you are the most vulnerable identity over there. Even if any thing is imposed on you, they won't do anything to you. They'll send back to India with a 5-year ban on you. So simple. So yahan pe koi dikkat wali baat nahi hai, bro. On arrival test both be required. Okay. I think we are done with all the questions. Right.
Yeah.
Okay, thank you so much for your time. And anything that you would like to add?
If anybody wants to like get in touch with me, you can share my number with them.
Yeah, definitely. I'll just tag you, tag your Instagram ID as well on this video. Okay,
sure.
Perfect. Thank you so much for your time.
Thank you. Yeah, bye.
Bye-bye.